Today, I'm Gianluca Furano, European Space Agency, and I will present you this acquisition, the use of the Owen RISC-V instruction set architecture for embedded space system. The case for RISC-V in space is pushed by the model nature of this ISA. They have the availability of a rich software ecosystem, rapidly growing community, and a pool of open source IP cores that will allow space industry to spin in developments from terrestrial fields while focusing its effort mainly on aspects related to the specific needs of onboard electronics for space application, like fault tolerance, observability. Embedded systems were born as space and dependable, were born with Viking and Voyager missions, where also most of the building blocks were developed, as well as specific instruction set architectures and software languages. So let's not forget that Voyager 2 works since 43 years without problems. And now the landscape is quite diverse, even if the prevalence of open ESA in space is a fact, and mostly driven by the SPARC instruction set architecture developed by ESA in the late 90s. Development of space grade processor is severely limited by user space. The most successful processor ever built, and that's the ESA ERC32, sold on the order of 16,000 pieces. So this is a completely different scale from commercial processor. To access to IP and foundries, so the non-recurring engineering costs with these scales are extremely high, the investment needs to be carefully thought before being put in place. And above all, physics. Radiation is a huge problem in space. We are talking about soft error rates that are several order of magnitudes higher than what experienced even the harshest ground environment. Availability of companion components like memories, thermal packaging, power supply issues, all play a role in restricting the user space of space processor. RISC-V has a specific place in the future that I will soon present, and it might be the replacement for the SPARC instruction set architecture that was so successful in Europe and in US in the past two decades. There is no alternative to progress. We are witnessing the same trends that are observable in commercial system in space. We are now having multi-core processors. We are limited in frequency by the thermal dissipation, so we might not arrive at several gigahertz of frequency, but we are limited at 300-400 MHz due to dissipation on 28-nanometer process. So we need something new to boost the efficiency, the single core efficiency, and to have a diverse landscape, of course, depending on the use. The whole choice of OpenISA was in the past among the ESA biggest successes. We have chosen for our processor SPARC V8 in 1992. At the time of this choice, it was perhaps the only fully OpenISA with significant backing. So this was, in a certain sense, was an easy choice. It was reasonably simple. So these arguments are valid today also for RISC-V. And friendly to low effort implementation, especially in VHDL, that gives us the portability to different technologies. Workstation existed using SPARC V8 compatible processor, so at the time we didn't need cross-compiling. Now with the virtualization, real-time emulation, this is not a requirement anymore. And we had already mature development tool with a mature GCC compiler and well-maintained, and we could be immediately part of a larger community to to stand on the shoulder of giants for what concerns maintenance of all the parts that we couldn't do with our only with our effort. So we are trying to replicate this success in 2020. We are pushing for availability of VHDL instantiation of RISC-V, investigating fault-tolerant adoption to specific target technologies. There are plenty of ESA projects already doing that. And we see in short term, I mean 1 to 3 years, adoption of RISC-V as soft core for radar FPGAs. In longer term, where longer term is 3 to 8 years, we see RISC-V as core for dedicated system on chip ASIC to replace the current Spark V8 workhorses. In this sense, Geisler Research is in the forefront of this effort, and it has already made public, open source, its Noel 5 architecture, fully based on RISC-V, with several different configurations, going from a tiny configuration mostly aimed at microcontrollers, very, very simple devices with no cache, no memory management unit, to a fully fledged 64-bit implementation with dual issue pipeline, FPU, cache, MMU. During the course of this year, at various stages of maturity, all this configuration will be available for researchers to play with. And we're looking forward to have feedback on that via Geisler or via ESA. So, to conclude, the open nature and modularity of the RISC-V ISA allows designers, also in a limited environment like space, to implement an optical microarchitecture for different applications. So, ranging from low performance, low power microcontrollers to the main onboard computer for the spacecraft, at the end up to high performance processor for machine learning and digital signal processing. RISC-V allows us to do all this with a single architecture. This is extremely important for space. The large number of RISC-V implementation that I have described and that are already available for space, some of them with very different requirements and target application, show how in a very little time RISC-V has allowed an unprecedented number of research. We are doing in 1 to 2 years what took 10 years at the time of Spark V8. The introduction of RISC-V in space will contribute to providing a range of alternatives to proprietary solution. And this is very important to guarantee continuity of space mission that have to last up to 30 years. And to enable new capabilities in satellite data system. As everybody else, we are concerned about growing monopolistic solution and the fact that we don't have access to the core ISA details. So if you want more detail, email me at the address in this last slide. The published material in this presentation can be found at the URL in this last slide. The roadmap, ESA roadmap for RISC-V in space has been published and you can find it at the other URL. So thank you very much for your attention and see you in person, I hope, very soon.